There's another paradigm shift, battle versus victory. Victory and battle. Victory and battle cannot coexist. They're opposite words. If you have victory, then you can't have battle. But if you're having battle, then you don't have victory. You can't have both at the same time. My question is, why are we struggling in the Christian life? Now, we can go the sin route if you want to, and I'm perfectly okay with you going sin. Everything is rooted in sin. We got to always, but here's the problem. What does the Bible say that the cure for sin is? Is it overcome it? No, that's not the cure for sin. You know what the cure for sin is? It's real simple. You die to it. And how do you die to it? Identifying with Christ on the cross. His death destroyed, broke the power of sin. Well, Ed, I still feel sin and powerful in my life. Well, then now we're at a different place. Let's ask the question, why? Why am I still struggling if the power of sin was broken and if I'm no longer in Adam, I'm now in Christ, and if I'm a new man in Christ Jesus and I came out of the tomb with him as a new man in Christ, walking a new way of life, then why am I still struggling? Well, we can say it's a sin problem. Okay, well, you only have one option there. You got the confess, repent, perform cycle. You can do that. Or we can say maybe there's some other element involved here. Maybe it's belief. Maybe my belief is somehow tied into my struggle. Because what happens if I know the truth with absolute certainty and that it in my heart of hearts, I know the truth? You know what the outcome is? It's called transformation. It's called the fruit of the Holy Spirit. And you know what? When I'm walking in the Spirit, guess what I'm not doing? I'm not fulfilling the lust of the deeds of the flesh. Why? Because you can't have the deeds of the flesh and the fruit of the Spirit at the same time. And as I know truth, walk in truth, grow in truth, at the heart level, I'm not talking about memorizing a Bible verse. Even lost people can do that. I'm talking about knowing the truth in your heart. The same way that you came to Christ, you believed in your heart and you were saved. Paul says, in the same way that you received Christ, walk in him. How did you receive him?
Faith,
belief. That's how you walk in him. Faith, belief. You didn't come to Christ, faith, and belief, and now let's go work out by doing something. It's faith. At the beginning, it's faith in the middle. It's faith on the end. Faith, purified faith, produces transformation. Struggle is exposure and an evidence of lies believed. We can walk in effortless victory in the areas in which we experientially know the truth.